Hi, my name is Patrick. This specific video is to tell you the three mistakes that people normally do while preparing for the NMAT exam. So I have written NMAT, I have scored 320, so I have a fair idea of the NMAT examination. So let's try to understand the pattern and let's try to look at what mistakes that students normally do in the exam. Okay, papers normally adapt your test like a GMAT. You can't come back to a question. So once you've gone to a question, you mark it and move forward. You need to guess mark in the question because there's no negative marking. You mark it and move forward. Okay, adaptive test also means that if you're getting the questions right, the questions will become more difficult. If you're getting it wrong, the question will become easy. Right, that's the adaptive test. But yes, the main thing is you cannot come back to the question and it makes sense to solve all the questions in the given time frame. 36 questions per section. So three sections, verbal, logic, quant. So that's where you need to plan the paper. And it's connected by GMAT. So the paper pattern sort of will be what the GMAT paper pattern is in terms of the way you write the examination. So let's look at what mistakes that people do. The first mistake that people do is preparing on extra topics. Now, since the NMAT papers like GMAT, they're very specific topics and they're very standardized. So only questions from those topics will come. But what happens, students end up preparing for topics that will not come in the exam. Okay, which means they are wasting a lot of efforts on things unexpected, like vocabulary is not expected. But if you spend too much time on vocabulary, it may not help, and so on and so forth. So you need to be very clear what type of questions are expected and accordingly prepare for the same. Paper is standardized, okay, and because every slot they have to give marks, so it's a standardized paper pattern. Remember, your score will depend only on how you perform in a test. It doesn't depend upon how others or it doesn't depend on the slot. So if you perform well in a test, you will get more marks. If you perform less in a test, you will get less marks. And it purely depends upon number of questions you answer in the question. Also, need not study topics like geometry, TSJ. Geometry is very vast. It is very important for CAT. But doesn't come in NMAT, so don't prepare. Same with TSJ. Similarly, for all the other areas, look at the questions that come in the NMAT and prepare those topics. There's no point preparing for topics that don't come in the NMAT. You'll be just wasting your time, right? So in that case, focus on the type of question that come in NMAT. Okay, look at the type of question. I already released a video on the topics that are in each of the areas, verbal, content, logic. Look at those videos and see what type of questions come and prepare accordingly. You can also look at this study guide, which is there. There also they mention the topics that come, which or type of question that come. That will also help you. So don't prepare for extra topics if you're focusing on NMAT. Look at those topics which have a higher weightage and accordingly prepare for them. Okay, people don't plan strategy. People just go and write the exam feeling that, okay, the more I solve, the better it is. But it's very important to plan your strategy before the exam. So spend some time on planning the paper. How do you plan the paper? Look at the type of question that come. You are aware of the type of question that come in the examination. For example, there's RCs, there's parajumbles, there's other questions in verbal. Look at the time that you take per type of question. So when you write a mock for NMAT, look at the time that you take for each type of questions. Okay, that will give you fair idea as to time spent on different type of question on a paper. Look at the marks per minute that you get in each type of question. Using that marks per minute, strategize. Try to find out how many questions you'll be able to solve and how many questions you'll not be able to solve. Okay, so that means from a 36 question, you realize that if I do my best, I can solve 30 questions. I know I'll be leaving 6 questions. So leave 6 questions where you spend more time and where you get less marks. For example, if I am very weak at RC and I don't get good marks, there's no spending time on one of the RCs. You can skip one RC completely without even reading it. Okay, that will save a lot of time. What people unfortunately do is to keep reading every question, which is a waste of time. There's no point, you know, reading and trying to solve every question which is there in the examination. Because the moment you start reading a question and trying to solve it, you will end up wasting time that will ensure that you're not able to solve enough questions. So it is important to plan in terms of how many questions are going to solve and how many questions are going to leave and what type. So in the exam, you're prepared for leaving questions which are tough or which you cannot solve or where you get less marks per minute. That will help you to get more time for questions that you get more marks per minute. Right? People don't write enough mocks. Again, if you made a plan, you need to follow it. And the best way to follow it is write the paper. Understand the adaptive test, unlike the other exams. So that means if you have not written enough adaptive tests, it becomes very difficult for you to plan the paper. So write down the paper, plan a paper. Okay, you require practice to ensure that you finalize the strategy. So practice enough papers so that you can finalize the strategy that is required for the exam. Right? I hope this will help. So do have a plan, do write enough mocks, and focus on the topics that come in the exam and prepare. That is what will help you to score well in the exam. Thank you.